Hey everybody, I'm working on our setup real quick. Give you guys a chance to join in. We're done with this stuff, so I don't need that. Get that out of the way. We're gonna be doing a little bit of Pilates. And I'm working on a pretty hard surface, so I'm going to give myself a double mat. And I just love this color combination. Isn't this pretty? It's sort of a pea soup green, almost sagey mint with this bright royal blue, which happens to match the sweater I'm wearing. That is cool. Color coordinated Pilates today. All right. So if you have a mat at home, you want to take that. You can also use a beach towel. You want a little bit of cushion, but you don't want to be anything too thick, or you won't be able to feel the floor. It's really important that you can feel the floor when we're working on this. In Pilates, everything we do is initiated from the core. So we do not use the glutes, the quads, the hamstrings. They want to work. We are not going to allow that to happen. I'm going to use this later, so I'll get this out of the way. We're going to use the belly. So just to kind of start engaging the belly, we're not going to start with our 100. Typically in a class setting, we would start with 100. And that's on a previous video if you want to go back and look at those. I am working on trying to get our YouTube channel organized into folders. I have a folder for our bar fitness, and there's one for yoga. I'll comment later the YouTube link for our page, but it's Stars in Motion 5678 without any spaces. And it's all lowercase, but I don't know if that matters on YouTube. Anyway, breathe up, hands are here, and activate the core. Another breath to get really tall. On the exhale, use your belly button to push back. Feel your body fall off the sits bones. Think about the vertebrae. Think of them as knuckles, okay? That you would roll one at a time into the floor. Take your time. Your hands are here. You're using your hands. If you get to here and you feel like you're just going to flop back, lift, hold on to one leg and lift it. Now, reach forward with that foot so that you have leverage and resistance there. The waist area is the hard part. And then roll all the way down into the floor. Try to feel the entire spine pushing down to the floor. And we do that with our belly and the feet, the whole foot. Please notice your glutes and your hamstrings. Are they engaged? If so, let them go. Give them a little wiggle. Let them go. All right, from here, we're going to lift our head up, lift our shoulders up. If we would like to hold that leg to help us rise, we can. So hold there and let that foot push you away. Roll up and then find your stretch. So you should notice all of this space really working. Like, I just kind of almost got a little cramp right there. We're going to call that was part of my six-pack, was cramping up, right? That's what we'll say. All right, so we're going to go ahead and start with rolling like a ball. Now, rolling like a ball is like its official Pilates name, but if you just want to be way more fun than that, we call it rock and roll, okay? So, if you get to come to my dance class, that's what we call it, rock and roll. But remember, you want to stay around. And watch this. Okay, I can kind of see, you're a little far from me, but I think I can see it. Watch, I just rounded my shoulders. So when I roll back, I'm going to flop flat onto the mat here. It is not going to feel good. So what you want to do is, I'm not going to engage my shoulders forward. Remember, it's belly button. Take your belly button and push it there. Now all of this rounded. The shoulders rounded too because they're connected. Shoulders round. Belly pulled back. See the difference? Be there. Now, you can, let's do the first set holding on here. So this gives our feet some movement and allows for momentum. All right, momentum is gonna be your friend for right now. So here's our breath, so we're gonna roll back. On the exhale, we're gonna roll up. Remember, we're trying to hit every vertebra along the way. That's kind of a hard word to say, isn't it? Vertebra. Sorry, it just came across my mind. I've had an extreme amount of caffeine today, so I'm gonna try to talk a little slower and keep my funny thoughts to myself. All right, ready, here we go. Here's your breath. And exhale, let your feet help you. Let the top of your head reach forward. That's really important when we stop using the legs for momentum. So breathing back, exhale, head comes forward. Now, if you did that and you're thinking, I got that, I can do that. Okay, then it's time to move to the next level. We're gonna take away some of the momentum. We're gonna hold on to the front of the leg. So there's not as much of this that can happen. All right, begin with your belly button pulled back, breathe and lower. Exhale, bring your head forward. And at this point, we're gonna start to think about not letting our feet touch the floor when we come up. How do you do that? Because remember, your head is going forward and you're gonna wanna smack those feet on the floor. Well, yeah, the head moves forward, but at some point, there has to be a break, just like in a car. So your break or your resistance, your pullback is here. It's that belly button to the spine. So as you come up, head forward, belly back, don't let the feet touch. Let's try that one. So here we are, or we're still here, wherever you're working, all right? Breathe, exhale, come forward, pull back, don't let the feet touch. Yeah, awesome. Now let's take a notice. I always like to, every once in a while, take a stretch. And let me just say this, this is your practice. If you can do 8, 10, 15 in a row and you don't need to stop and take a stretch, then you go on and do that. But if you did 2 and you felt like your belly was getting a little cramp in there, then you need to stop and stretch. Listen to your body and do what it says, all right? You either do what it says or it will make you do it. Next phase, if you wanna, hands on heels. This one's hard. I hope I can do this. Forehead towards the knees or touching the knees, and you wanna try to stay there. Where's the belly button? It's pulled back to the spine, working toward the mat. Here's our breath. Toes are off the floor. Exhale, come up, pull back, pull back, pull back. Oh, I got a cramp. Yeah, isn't that crazy? So if you do, like, I wanna challenge you right now. You find one of those three that we just did, okay? And I want you to do 10. And at that point, we're gonna stop and do some stretches, and I've got another exercise for us to do. But I want you to notice tomorrow or maybe the next day, maybe you feel some work that happened in there, a little bit of a good sore. All right, so here we are. We're gonna try to do 10. And actually, y'all, I got a little low battery notification. I'm just gonna close that out so I can see what we're doing. All right, so here we go. And since I did get a cramp in my belly, I'm gonna hold here and not on my feet and be as rounded as possible. Toes are off the floor if you choose to do that. And we breathe back. Exhale, front. There's one. Breathe. Exhale, we're not coming back to the sits bones. We're staying in that very low spine. That's 3. Stay in that ball position. 4. Pull back with your belly button and with that bottom rib. I think this is 5. Exhale. Breathe. Exhale. Really use that breath out. I kind of forgot to count because this feels really good on my back. Let's call this 10. And release. Take your stretch. Ah, that should feel really, really nice. Good. All right, we're gonna go right into shoulder bridge. And it's the same idea as far as articulation goes. And let me just say this, shoulder bridge is hard Okay, so if you're like, oh, sure, I've got that. Okay, this is not a glute exercise. This is a torso, abdomen, oblique exercise. We're working the back as well. So if your glutes are engaged and you're using hamstrings to make this happen, or if you're using shoulders more than just a little bit, then we need to talk about it. So here we go, we're gonna go all the way down. Remember, this is how we get down. We're up, the belly button pushes down, and we take our time, and we hold one leg if we need to, and we go all the way down. Now from here, I'm gonna actually take my hands out to the side so you can see my lower back. Okay, y'all, I'm gonna make it so you can see my lower back a little bit better. Okay. Didn't want to be disrobing on our video. So here we are. Now, really watch this part of the back, because that's the hard part to get down there.
No, no.
All right. And your hands can be here, they can be overhead, they can be here at first, especially if you want to let them help you a little bit. Remember, no glutes, no hamstrings, no quads. Right now, I want you to place an imaginary balloon right between your knees. Don't pop it. Don't drop it, all right? We're gonna use the feet, including the toes, the whole foot, and we're gonna take our breath, and as we breathe in, we're gonna push the belly button down, and notice, I'm going to exaggerate this because you won't quite see what you can feel, but you'll notice a slight upward lift of the tailbone. That's when the glutes wanna pop in, and you're gonna be like, no, you sit down, this is for my core. So we're gonna breathe and push the belly down. Use your feet, not your rear. And as we continue that breath, we're gonna try to roll through the waistband. It's extremely difficult to do this. By the way, where's your balloon? Hold on to that. We're gonna get into our exhale, and as we exhale, our shoulders are gonna push down, our feet are pushing down, our glutes are free. All of this, these two hip bones are lifting up. Now here comes the hard part. On this next breath, we're gonna drop the heart, but leave the belly. And then on the exhale, we're gonna articulate one vertebra at a time, all the way down. Notice two things. Where's your balloon? What are your glutes doing? I know, it's so hard. All right, ready? Here we go. Breathe. Exhale, use the feet, let the shoulders give a push. Keep the belly lifted. Breathe, drop the heart. Exhale, unfold all the way down. Twice more, breathe up. Use the belly and the feet. Don't use the hips. Drop the heart. Allow the belly to push down. Belly down. No glutes. Don't drop the balloon. Bring it in. All right, we're gonna come in. For time's sake on the video, I'm not gonna go ahead and do 10 of those. But I said 10, it can be any amount that you want to. You can do 8, take a break and do some stretches and come back and do some more. Because we're using our core, and anytime you're using a muscle, I know you've seen bodybuilders, I see one every day. When Mike works out, he's like lifting heavy weights, and I'm always trying to get him to stretch. Bless his heart, he has a hard time with some particular stretches behind the back. But they're building mass, and that's awesome. It looks nice. But we don't want this to happen here. We want this to be long and lean, right? So how do we combat that? We stretch and we roll. So, we're gonna do a little bit of a different kind of belly stretch. We're gonna put the roller just above the knee, okay? By the way, we have a free body rolling class this Saturday, April the 29th at 9 a.m. at the farmer's market. All right, so from here, I feel like it needs to be down a little bit more. Right above the knee, relax everything here, let the belly button go down so your back is arched. If that's too much arch for you, come on down to this position. Or if you'd like more arch in the back, come on up
and lower there. You might even do it with your hands all the way up, but my belly won't touch the floor with my hands, my arms all the way up. So that's a little stretch there. Now that's a lot on the lower back. So we're gonna push down with our legs and bring the belly button up through the spine. Continue the push, bring it around through the shin and find our little child's pose here. Rest it down. Here's a really good front ankle stretch also. Y'all look funny upside down. All right, feet together, squeeze the heels and push there. Feel that. That's nice. And we'll come on around. All right, that was shoulder bridge. What else are we doing? Lower back stretches, that was one of them. You can also do shoulder bridge on the roller, but we'll do that at another time and maybe in a face-to-face class. It's not something that's kind of like a next step that we might not be ready for just right now. If you are in a place where you can do a twist, then that's what we're gonna do next. If you are with child, please do not do this exercise with me. If you are having spasm, near spasm, any kind of really super incredible lower back pain going on, you do not want to do this one. You can be here, crossed over. So if you are having some sort of a pain and you just want to be here and lift all of this out there, that's a really nice one. And we've got another one we're fixing to come into as well. So this stretch and one more, and we'll be through with our video. I'm going to go ahead and cross over because I feel like I can do that today. If you've been following my progress these past 6 weeks, I hurt my back a little while ago and I'm feeling so much better. So I've prayed that God would release that pain and He's allowed me some therapies that did so. So I'm excited. We're going to breathe and lift up this hand. Now, as we come around, several things are happening. This hand and this leg are resisting one another. I'm lifting up and pushing down and opening, and my palm is heavy. So even though I'm here, I'm holding a heavy textbook and I'm having to really push against that. Now let your eyes take you to your greatest stretch. So wherever you can see, you can reach. Breathe it up. Bring it around. And remember, we're also listening to our body. So if your body said, hey, I know your eyes can look further back than that, but you can't stretch further back than that today, you need to listen. And we're going to the other side, and that's like raising another child. They're going to be different. Resist here, reach here, hold that heavy book, lift up and push down. And look as far as you can, reach as far as you can look, breathe it up, come around. All right, so you probably felt that in the middle back. That's kind of where we were aiming for. This one we're gonna aim much lower. Feet are apart, so from the shoulders down the ribs, down the hips, to the heels. That's where we're going. Toes are straight out in the front. So we're on parallel tracks. Hands are here, here, or here. I'm actually going to turn a little bit so you can see a little bit more of what I'm doing there. I really like this position because I can grip my hands and I feel more resistance. The resistance is a key part of this exercise. Remember, we're thinking about our lower back. And it's your body, it's your brain. You get to send the messages to the parts that you want to stretch. So you be in charge of that. Take control of yourself. Now, I'm pushing out so hard that if I were to move my hands, my legs will open. And the same thing, if I were to stop pushing, my arms would pull in. So the resistance is here and here. Also, energy is moving here and here. So your heart is reaching to the horizon. Your belly button and your, let's not say belly button, let's say bottom rib. Your bottom rib is pulling forward toward your inner thighs. Shoulders are back and down. The dandelion effect is in full motion here. Breathing and exhaling, and we are pushing energy in every direction. Shoulders are down and back, and they're wide. Now, where are we sending our energy and our focus?
to that low, low back. Feel your hips releasing from one another. I'm trying to find the right words here. I think that's one way you can see that. And try to push the pelvic floor toward the mat, forward. Take a big breath. On the exhale, release and dive the head forward. Let all of that go. Hands are here or here, wherever you can get the best reach. Head reaches forward. Middle spine reaches back. And release out of that. Awesomeness. Thank you so much for joining me on my video today. And I think I've taken just enough time that the storm has passed, and I'm not going to get rained on when I load the car up with all of our rolling stuff for our body rolling class on Saturday. If you ever have a question about anything, you can message me here on our Facebook page, comment on the videos. If there's something that you would like to see, a video that you wish that we would do, or something you're having some trouble with and you need some explanation, or maybe there's a pose that you're having a hard time holding or getting into, I can try to see if either myself or someone on our staff can help you with that. And I hope that you have a wonderful rest of the week and a really good sleep on this nice rainy night. I'll see you next time.